Life in the Big Smoke isn't always easy for our native birds. In order to survive, they have to run the gauntlet of introduced predators such as cats and rats, and avoid hazards like cars or flying into windows. Sometimes they get injured and come off second best. That's why the bird rescue ladies around Auckland are so important. Get into rescuing birds.
Started off with my husband bringing home a little scaup, a little diving duck, and getting to the point where I didn't quite know what to do with it because I couldn't get it to eat. And I took it through to one of the other rescue ladies, Hilary Stollery, and just watching her work with it was just amazing. Putting tubes down its throat and doing this and doing that, I just thought I need to know how to do this and haven't looked back since. This is the kingfisher. We're actually going to hand feed him.
How come he ended up in your hospital?
He'd hit a window. You know, if that happens, rather bring it in. They could actually have just kept him for a while, left him in a cardboard box just to get warm and just relax him a bit, and he probably would have been fine.
But you've got a special permission, haven't you, to look after these birds?
Yes, I do. I have a permit from DOC to care for these birds. I cannot keep them. If they cannot be rehabilitated and released, unless I can home them with a zoo or somewhere like Otahonga, I would probably have to have them put down.
There are things you can do to stop birds from flying into your windows. You can hang something in them or even put stickers on them so that you can discourage them from flying away. But now it's his turn to fly away, so we'll let you go. This little kingfisher was caught in parapara, which is a native tree, but it's a real problem for birds because the tree's got these big, long, sticky kind of bud bits on the end. Insects get caught in them and the birds come down to look at the insects and also get caught. Their feathers get gunged up.
I've got his head covered purely because I don't want to stress him out any more than he is.
Yep.
And transferring him to this aviary, it's going to be a bit of a fright for him because it's very big. Very different from what he has been in.
So he might.
So he could flip out a little bit. But it's like everything, it's just taking time. So he is a snapper.
How important is it for you to work with the other bird rescue ladies throughout the Auckland area?
Oh, it's terribly important. We couldn't cope with the numbers that we have if we didn't work with each other. There's eight different centres and we're located all around Auckland, and we all have a very good relationship.
It is possible for our native wildlife to live among us in towns and cities, but sometimes they need a little extra TLC. People like Mandy help ensure that our sick and injured townie birds have a chance to survive. Because there's no